walking pattern with layers. So this would definitely be an intermediate skill. This pattern will have not just walking, but will also have hip articulations and upper body. So we have a lot of stuff going on in this, but we're gonna go through it one part at a time and break it all down. So if you do like drills like this, please do remember to go ahead and hit like down there and also just subscribe so that you know when the next one's coming up. All right, let's get to work. All right, so let's talk about how we're gonna break this complex pattern down. So this has three parts to it. So I'm gonna call this an A, B, and C part. So A is just walking, so that is easy. So just right and left and right and left, whether you're going forward or backwards or side to side. So the first part of your pattern is just to walk. The second part of your pattern is gonna be a three-quarter on the up. So from here, basic three-quarters. So you're gonna have one, two, three, one, two, three. Just up with your hips, left, right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left. So that's your second component. Now component C is gonna be a vertical chest circle. So that is right here. Side up and over the top, and another way, right here. So those are your three parts. Now, if you are a newer dancer, either the three-quarter on the up or the chest circle are new for you, then you're gonna wanna make sure that you get those things down first before you start putting these things together. All right, so first we're gonna just look at A plus B. So A is your three-quarter pattern on your hips, so up on the right, up on the left, up on the right. So that is with no weight change at all, but when we put that with our walk, then we have stepping, and we're gonna step on the first count. So we have one, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Coming back. And of course you can move sideways, just stepping it together. And if you want to go the other way. So the important thing is that the first and third articulation on your hip are on your weighted leg, and that's where you make the transfer. So you make the transfer of one, two, three. So if you want more help with this, I did do a whole DVD on a full on the three-quarter shimmies, which is all walking three-quarter shimmies, and I did five varieties of that. So you can check down there for a streaming of that DVD if you would like more three-quarter shimmy patterns or a lot of help breaking down that particular one. All right, so let's move along. We just did A and B. Now we're going to do A and C. Okay, now let's look at parts A and C together. So A is your walk and C is your rib circle. So your vertical rib circle right here, and you can do this in either direction that you like. The important thing to remember is it's going to be one full circle per step. So no matter which direction you'd like to go, you're going to start from the bottom and then you're going to go around and make one full circle with each step. So as I step, that's where my ribs will go, and they'll finish the circle before I make the next step. And we're going to continue taking our circles all in the same direction for this. You could definitely switch your directions up if you like, and that'll be a nice extra kind of complicated variation afterwards, but try it all in one direction first. So one step, one circle, one step, one circle, one step, one circle, going back, going back, going back, and back, now to the side, out, and together, and out, and together, and out, and together, switch sides, out, together, out, together, out, together. All right, so when I was moving to the side, I was going away from my body, so going in the direction of travel and over the top, but you could totally do that the other way. So you could go over this way and take your ribs in the opposite direction. So it's really whatever you like. Okay, now here's the tough part, putting parts B and C together. So part B, remember, is the three-quarter pattern on your hips, and part C is the rib circle. So with your hips, we're going to count one, two, three, one, two, three. So one three-quarter pair for each side as the ratio for one circle. Now I'm going to match the three-quarter on one side with one part of the circle. So one half of the circle. I'm going to divide my circle this way. So I have a half on this side and a half on this side, and they're both going to belong to the parts of my hips on the same side, if that makes any sense. So here, I'm going to take my ribs from the side to the top with this side, and then from the side to the bottom with this side. So up to the top, down to the bottom, up to the top, down to the bottom, up to the top, down to the bottom, up to the top, down to the bottom. We'll go the other way. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, like that. All right, so that's how B and C go together. And they are definitely the two hardest parts to put together. Now we're going to put A, B, and C all together. So we're going to start from here, and we're going to have up to the top, down to the bottom, up, down, circle, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, go back, like that. All right, so all of these things take some practice. Remember, when you're putting three things together, you want all of your parts first to be able to be done separately. And then before you start loading 1, 2, and 3 all on top of each other, you want to make sure 1 and 2, or A and B, whatever you want to call it, the first two go together, the other two go together. So every pairing has, you work that out to make sure that you have kinks out of that and that you can do that smoothly. So that's when you put the third thing in. All right, so we're going to do a little bit of drill, slow with some music, and then just a little bit faster. All right, so this is the 80 beats per minute rhythm track. So if you like to use a metronome, this will give you an idea of what the speed might be. So we're going to start here, and we're going to build in with this first one. So we're going to have step, 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 step. Part A is just your walk. Part B is your hips. This is their pace. Circles up. our pattern for today. So I know we went through a lot of different steps right there, and we went through them kind of quickly. So you can definitely take your time with all of those with a rhythm track or a metronome that is at your speed for putting part A and B, A and C, and B and C together before you pile it all up. So like I said, if you want more help with three-quarter shimmies, I do have a full DVD for one with three-quarter shimmies, which does go over 5 walking three-quarter shimmies. This thing right here is about over 2 hours long, I think, with a combination for each style of three-quarter walking shimmy. So if you want information on this, you can look in the box down there. So if you like this video, please do go ahead and give it a like and subscribe. If you are not already subscribed to the Bellydance Quickies email list, which also includes Wednesday and Friday editions, which are not on YouTube, you can also find information for that down there. Other than that, we are all done for today. So have a wonderful week, keep practicing, and then we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.